Praise God, family, it's Jazz. I wasn't planning on coming back on and doing any more uploads tonight. However, I just feel really led to come on and just share with you guys a discussion I had with my son tonight. I just recently reshared his Wednesday Rapture revelation discussion that we had a couple months ago. He talked about Jesus telling him that he was coming on Wednesday. Just so happens to be a date that we're watching, 7/26, which is Pentecost, per Leviticus 23:16. Also watching 7/27 and even into 7/28 and the rest of July, as this will conclude the wheat harvest. But especially tomorrow, the 26th, the 27th, and the 28th, all three of these dates have a Strong's Concordance meaning of a sudden departure or sudden snatching away. We know 7/26 is harpazo. 7/27 is a sudden snatching. So the 26th would be Tuesday here, Wednesday in Israel. 7/27 is Wednesday here, and Thursday in Israel, the new moon. So we're watching the rest of July for the coming of the Lord. And that's really what we talked about tonight with my son. So again, I shared that Wednesday dream. I heard him speak about Wednesday maybe two or three times after that. He is always talking about the Lord coming, but tonight was a little different. Some of the things that he said, if you didn't see the original video, I'm just explaining how he was born 2 months early, how he's developmentally delayed, how he doesn't know the days of the week, but he said Jesus told him Wednesday. That's the only day of the week that I've ever heard him speak of, because he doesn't know the days. He still doesn't know the days of the week yet. But that was just something that he said the Lord told him. So tonight he gave me another revelation of seeing Jesus and talking to Jesus. And he, out of nowhere, guys, literally, we had just got done praying for tonight. They were getting ready for bed. I stepped away to the bathroom. I said, I'll be right back. And when I come out, we are going to lay down. And so maybe about 15 minutes getting cleaned up, I came out, I was getting ready for bed, and he was sitting on the bed. And whether or not he got this within the 15 to 20 minutes I was getting cleaned up for tonight, I'm just not sure, but it was very random. The first thing I heard him say was, Jesus is coming, which is not uncommon for him. But he followed this up with very strange, like scripturally, something that's in the scriptures that he wouldn't know because he's not there yet. He's not reading or anything like that. But he said, Jesus is coming. He said, his house is broken up. He literally said, his house is broken up. And that prompted me to start recording him. I wish I would have been able to get that part, but like I said, this was out of nowhere. So I do have a clip, two clips that I'm gonna clip in for you guys. It's not gonna be an audio recording like before. You're actually gonna be able to see his body language in this one. So hopefully this encourages you, but I just wanna give a little commentary on what he was saying, because some things can be hard to pick up on just because he's not where he should be. So after he said that his house was broken up, I started recording again. Then he started talking about Jesus bleeding, like always. He's pointing to his hands. Then he grabbed both of his feet. I'm not gonna include that part in it. I just wanna include like the main things, because he was clearly talking about the rapture. And you guys heard him speak of that before, but he kept talking about Jesus bleeding. He said that Jesus was angry, but he said that Jesus was not crying. Now, why he wanted me to know that Jesus was angry but not crying, I will never know. He told me that Jesus was sitting on the bed. Again, I don't know if this is when I walked away from him after prayer or not. I just don't know. But he said Jesus was sitting on the bed, and he told Jesus, I'll include that part in, he says he told Jesus not to sit on the bed because he didn't want Jesus to get blood on the bed, but he was very sad. He said he was crying. He said that Jesus picked him up, that he was very strong, that he was giant, and he said that he gave Jesus a hug. He said he was crying because Jesus was bleeding. And then it got even more strange. He started talking about everything being giant. He said that Jesus was giant, and he said that Jesus was sitting in a giant chair in the clouds. So you guys will see that, and you'll see him pointing up in the video. Now, when I was recording the video, he said something that I did not pick up on until I went back and watched the video, because I sent it to my mother. So after he said that Jesus was sitting in a giant chair in the clouds, he also said there was a giant door. Now, when I was recording that, because I think I was speaking the same time he was, I just didn't pick up on what he was saying. But you'll be able to hear it very clearly, because I was. He said Jesus, and he was talking about a giant door, and he's pointing up, like just like with the Wednesday revelation. You guys couldn't see that one because it was audio. But he kept pointing up and saying Jesus was at the door, rather than pointing at the door that's always right in front of him. He's pointing up and he's saying Jesus is at the door. He's sitting on a giant chair. So not a throne, but a chair, because obviously he wouldn't know what that is. So when he said that, I immediately thought of Revelation 4:1, which is the rapture, where John sees a door open in heaven, and then we're immediately caught up to the throne of God. And I think that's what he was seeing. And he made it very clear, like, this is not something that was said. He talks about seeing Jesus. He saw this. He saw Jesus sitting on the bed. So he makes it very clear this is not just something he was hearing, but something he was actually seeing. Then he started talking about giant houses. So he had talked about seeing Jesus giant, the chair giant, and the door giant, and the clouds. But then he also started talking about giant houses. And he said he didn't know what it was, but he said it was a giant house. And then he looks down and says, but this house is not giant. So he's like making a delineation from the houses that he saw and the house that we were in. We're at my parents' house right now, which is fairly large. It's a new construction. It has 3 floors, finished basement, 2nd floor, upstairs floor, like 4 bathrooms. So this house is pretty big. But he said that this house was not giant, but the house that he saw was giant. A lot of things he just kept repeating, but I want to share just the relevant parts, because again, he started this discussion with Jesus is coming and that his house was broken up. So I just wanted to share this with you guys. I wanted to just share some commentary. Hopefully it helps you hear him and understand him better. But I want to play those clips for you guys. Hopefully, again, it encourages you. Again, I don't know if this is something the Lord just revealed to him, or if this is something he's been seeing. But the only thing he's been saying lately is what he always say, and that's just Jesus is coming. And that's just because I'm always saying it. But tonight was different. He was letting me know he saw things. So as always, take it to the Lord in prayer. Be vigilant, be encouraged. Hopefully this encouraged you, because it definitely encouraged me. We're watching 7:26. That's Tuesday again. It'll be 7:27 in Israel. So I'm gonna play those 2 clips for you guys right now. Again, take it to the Lord in prayer. If I don't make another video, I hope to see you guys in the clouds. Till next time, love in Christ.
But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched, and would not have suffered his house to be broken up.
He got a giant chair. Up there at the clouds, he got door giant.
He got a giant chair in the clouds.
I don't know what is that. It's very giant. But this other house is not giant. He mad. And
why is he mad?
But he's not crying.
He's mad though.
But he's not crying.
He's mad, but he's not crying?
Yeah, but I just see him at the bed bleeding, sitting down on the bed. I said, don't sit at the bed. This bed gonna bleed. I thought Jesus exercised, he's stronger, but I just told him he's very strong.
He who testifies to these things says, yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.